alert forecast, and the heat is definitely on here in Central Florida.
And when it mixes in with that humidity, it is really steamy out there. First Alert meteorologist Jason Brewer has a look at what the conditions are like right now.
Yeah, right now, Executive Airport reporting 88 degrees, mostly sunny skies, no storms yet. In fact, our sea breeze will be a bit delayed today like it was yesterday. So we are expecting a little bit later start to the storms compared to, say, the 4th of July, where we had rain already on the radar about this time. There's Claremont, 87, some high clouds, a couple of pop-up cumulus clouds there, no rain at this time, of course. We have 87 at Daytona Beach and Melbourne. The sea breeze will be moving in shortly, but it will be delayed north of the Cape. So look at these heat index readings. No sea breeze in Palm Coast, so our weather watcher there reporting a 100-degree feels-like temperature right now as of the noon hour. Feels like 94 in Orlando, 96. Current heat index in the Villages. Hopefully most folks are finished up with the golf round already on this Friday lunch hour. There's the sea breeze now just making its first appearance at Cocoa Beach, and we are tracking it very carefully through the afternoon as it makes its way westward, because that's where we'll start to see the showers and storms popping up as usual this time of the year. High temperature today around Ocala and the Villages about 93, Paisley to Winter Garden, Orlando right around Longwood, Sanford about 94. You see Cocoa checking in at 90 degrees, but along the sand it'll be in the upper 80s. Palm Coast, New Smyrna Beach heating up into the lower 90s this afternoon, where that sea breeze will be coming in a few hours later than it will be south of the Cape. Surf temperature, low 80s, so you can hit the water and cool off, but do be advised the rip currents have been an ongoing issue, and with a lot of folks at the beaches this weekend, I'm sure Beach Patrol will have their hands full. So do them a favor, stay nearby the lifeguard towers so you can get help if you need to get caught, if you do get caught in one of those rips. Now, hour by hour tonight, we're going to keep those rain chances at 30% downtown through about 5 o'clock, but then creep them back up heading into about 7 and 9 to 40%, where our sea breeze collision is likely to start occurring. There's 8 o'clock tonight, right up and down I-4, possibly a little farther west or east, just depends on exactly where all the boundaries start to meet up. Saturday morning, plenty of sun, a bright start to the day. Look what happens on Saturday afternoon. A little more of an inland push to our sea breeze here off the Atlantic, so that's going to mean pretty good beach weather. Not only today, but especially on into the weekend. In fact, Sunday we wake up dry, and then an even farther inland push, it looks like, on Sunday afternoon to that breeze. So best beach weather, clearly Brevard, where the sea breeze is coming in first, but we can't rule out one or two little storms still affecting the coast for the Coke Zero 400. Here's the tropical report real quickly. Notice how we're nice and quiet. There's one tropical wave coming into eastern Cuba now. The moisture from this will be staying to our south over the weekend, but it does look like South Florida may see a little extra rain from that. There's your 7-day forecast. Temperatures in the low 90s, 40% on the storms. Next week, more moisture on the way, bumping up those rain chances to 50% on Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday. Back to you.
Jason, thank you.